Peter, I wanted to ask about, we've been speaking to a lot of contextual technology companies. It's become much more relevant for various reasons we'll explore. But in terms of, you know, your role in the marketplace, you know, serving, you know, the buy side primarily, what is the function that your company provides? How do you define its differentiation?
Yeah. So explaining the point of difference, I think, you know, contextual has, you know, is a huge catch-all for what I would refer to as kind of brand relevance. And it's generally just been used in one specific way. We sit in the contextual space, but we do things that are quite different to what has been, you know, the traditional way of viewing contextual for, you know, for targeting purposes, which is to try to place an ad on a page that is relevant, you know, a context that's relevant to the brand that's advertising, sports branding, sports content, for example. So we're in that category, but we are very different. So we're an AI company that specializes in contextual targeting. And what we do is we use machine learning to learn in campaigns, so using live signals from a campaign to isolate contexts that are driving the best engagement, if you like, that are effectively creating the right, what we refer to as a contextual moment for that particular campaign. And then we built a recommendation engine that basically allows you to perpetually change your contextual targeting in near real time to capitalize on these fleeting user behaviors where they're, you know, they're sort of in the right contextual moment for that particular campaign. So it's somewhere as a sort of hybrid between context and audience. Which is, we're using context as the reason why we target the page, but we're using an audience signal to determine whether or not it's the right context for that campaign.
And tell us how you guys work with partners, particularly the buy side DSPs. I know you're working with Xandr, I'm sure others. How are you integrated into the DSP proposition?
So we are, you know, effectively another type of targeting technology that advertisers can use. You know, our core use case, you know, we developed technology not to be just a, you know, a contextual targeting cookie-less solution. We developed it to allow people to do two things that were previously thought to be that couldn't coexist, which is driving up scale and reach in a campaign whilst maintaining performance. And so we're effectively a line item, another targeting technology alongside audience and what I would refer to as traditional brand relevant contextual. And then effectively they would target an Illuma segment effectively, which would allow them to capitalize. And those segments are different to things that have gone before in programmatic, where they are generally static segments. You buy an audience and that is your audience for that campaign, and it will change very little during the campaign. Same with contextual, you may make some manual changes. As is very different to capitalize on context for the reasons of trying to find the best outcomes for a campaign, you have to perpetually change it. So in the back end, we are perpetually changing the kind of pages and contexts based on what the, so we need DSPs that have that capability basically to allow us to pass information dynamically into the segment so that traders can capitalize on these contextual behaviors.
Peter, I wanted to ask you about the big transformations going on right now, the deprecation of the mobile ID, new regulations coming out or new guidelines coming from Apple. Of course, the deprecation of third-party cookies. Is that something that, and of course, the ongoing impact of GDPR and new regulations coming out of California. How has that impacted your business or sort of the opportunity for contextual advertising?
Yeah. So, you know, contextual is obviously overcomes a lot of, you know, the sort of challenges that are coming into the industry. So without the need for identifiers and a number of other things, which are proving to be, you know, not particularly desirable at the present moment, people are starting to look at context. But I think from the perspective of how has it impacted us and contextual in general, I think positively, and by that I mean not as just a throwaway comment, of course everybody's interested in context. I mean, I think context and the, if we term context as the momentary content consumption of an audience as opposed to the historical content consumption of an audience where you store that information on an identifier, you know, really context is just the real-time part of that same user journey, if you look at it that way. And there has been very, very little investment or investigation or even, frankly speaking, that much interest in its, in the role it plays and the very, very significant role it plays in online advertising success more broadly. And that's not new. You know, that's something that's existed since the beginning of ad targeting. It's just that as an industry, there was almost this sort of, I wouldn't use the word obsession, is perhaps a little strong, but that there was only really one truth in finding on relevance for online advertising for an audience, and that was personalization. It was to say there is no other, and it's almost as if everything else was sort of blocked out. It's like you can do contextual, but that's kind of a different thing. You've got a bucket for contextual, that's where you target an ad against content that's about your brand, you know, sports brand, sports content. And then you've got audience, which is really where this is where we should all be spending our time. It's about personalization and all of that sort of stuff. And it's like nothing else, no other kind of relevance exists. And that's meant nobody really paid attention to the more nuanced ways in which you might be able to develop contextual in a different way, invest in that area. What can happen if we put artificial intelligence, you know, sort of machine learning algorithms into it? If we take signals from a campaign, if we look at location, if, none of that was being done because the industry was kind of just looking over here and saying, well, let's just try and find different ways of doing personalization. And it's so, to coming back to your original question, it's like, you know, is it having a sort of positive effect? I think for contextual generally, it's just making people think more creatively about the opportunities that actually have always existed. It's just that these browser changes, that some of the, you know, legislation that's coming in is basically now saying to people, well, now we're going to kind of force you to be a little more creative and imaginative with finding other ways to find people at the right moment. So I think it's positive for contextual for reasons beyond it just being a cookie-less, if you like, targeting method.